Hello students, today we are going to discuss defects of vision and their correction. Sometimes the eye may gradually lose its power of accommodation. In such conditions, the person cannot see the objects distinctly and comfortably. The vision becomes blurred due to the refractive defects of the eye. There are mainly three common refractive defects of vision. These are myopia or nearsightedness, hypermetropia or farsightedness, and presbyopia. These defects can be corrected by the use of suitable spherical lenses. We will discuss the defects one by one in detail. First defect, that is myopia. Myopia or short-sightedness. What is short-sightedness? That means the view of the person is shortened. That means for a normal eye, the far point is infinity. But for a myopic person, his far point is not infinity. When the object is at infinity, what happened? The image is formed in front of the retina. If the image is on the retina, then only we will get the sensation of vision. How can you define myopia? Myopia means a person can see near objects clearly but not able to see the distant object. That means he doesn't have any problem in his near point. His near point is 25 cm only, but his far point is not infinity. Now we will see what is the cause of myopia or nearsightedness. The cause is that elongation of the eyeball. And other reason is that the converging power of the eye lens increases. That means the focal length of the eye lens decreases. That means the lens become more thick. This is the reason for myopia. Next is, how can we rectify myopia? With the help of ray diagram, we will see how this problem is solved. See, this is a myopic eye. Where is his far point? Here. That means his far point is limited. When the object is at his far point, the image is formed on the retina. But if the object is at infinity, the image is formed in front of the retina. So, the converging power of this eye lens is more. If we want the image on the retina, we have to decrease the converging power of the lens. That means to reduce the converging power of the lens, we have to use a diverging lens. See, when we keep a diverging lens or concave lens in front of the eye, what it did? It obtained the image of the object placed at infinity to the far point of the myopic person. That means, if the object is at infinity, for this lens, the image is where it is, the image is at the far point of the myopic person. That means for an eye lens, now the object is his far point only. So the image is formed on the retina. That means by using a concave lens of suitable focal length, we can rectify myopia. Next is hypermetropia. You can see here, for hypermetropic person, the image is formed behind the retina. That means a person cannot see the near object clearly. He is having problem in his near point. His near point recedes away from 25 cm. This type of defect is called hypermetropia. It is also called hyperopia or farsightedness. What is the cause of hypermetropia? First cause, the eyeball become too small. Second is, the focal length of the eye lens increases. It become too long. Eyeball too short or refractive power of the eye too weak. Parallel rays of light are brought to focus behind the retina with the accommodation relaxed. Now we will see how can we rectify hypermetropia. We will explain with the help of ray diagram. For a hypermetropic person, his near point is not 25 cm. It recedes away. Now his near point is here. When the object is at his near point, no problem, the image is formed on the retina. But when the object is at the near point of a normal person, that time the image is formed behind the retina. But he has to see the things from normal near point. So what we will do? We will keep a converging lens of suitable focal length in front of his eye. Why we want to keep a converging lens? Because you can see here the image is formed behind the retina. That means the converging power of the eye lens decreases. To increase the converging power, we have to keep another converging lens in front of the eye. Now, how this converging lens work here? We can see that when we keep a converging lens in front of the eye, the image of the object placed at the normal near point is obtained on his near point. That means for this defected eye lens, the object is at his near point only. That time, no problem, the image is formed on the retina. Convex lens placed in front of the eye obtain the image of the object placed at his near point to the near point of the hypermetropic person. So finally, the image is formed on the retina. We can rectify hypermetropia by using convex lens of suitable focal length. This topic is very important. All of you write, what is meant by hypermetropia? What causes it? With the help of ray diagram, explain how hypermetropia is rectified. Next topic is presbyopia. Presbyopia is also a type of hypermetropia. The person is not able to see the near objects clearly. Actually, this is not a defect. This is happening in every person due to aging. The lens ages and stiffens, bringing the focal point behind the retina and causing blurry vision. But the ray diagram and all same for hypermetropia. Here also we will use a convex lens of suitable focal length to rectify this problem. Sometimes pupil suffer from both myopia and hypermetropia. This case they have to wear bifocal lens of suitable focal length. Bifocal lens is the combination of convex lens and concave lens. Okay students, I think you all understood the defects of eye. We discussed here what is meant by myopia, what causes it, how can we rectify it, then hypermetropia, the same things we discussed, and then presbyopia. All of you draw the ray diagrams and learn it well. Thank you.